Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. Today we'll be talking about Web3 technologies and present 6 ways how companies can use the Web3 technologies to have competitive advantages in the market. So without any further ado, let's dive deep into it. But before we start, this video is
only for educational purposes, if not financial advice,
and let's get into it.
So guys, we start here with the definition of Web3. What's Web3? Web3 in a nutshell here is a decentralized internet built on an open blockchain network that's not owned or controlled by any large entity, meaning that Web3 is a new wave of internet. It's the third generation of the internet and it's currently being built. It's on the go right now. It's existing, but it's being developed, and where websites and apps are able to process information in a smart human-like way through technologies such as artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data, and decentralized ledger technology, DLT, and more. Currently, as we speak, Web3 has been taking the whole entire world by storm. Everyone is just competing to utilize Web3 to the best, but currently we're in the transition zone between Web2 and Web3. So we're kind of stuck within Web 2.5, if you can define it like that. As you can see here, we're currently getting into a prolongated era of Web 2.3, where we can have the transition between Web2 and Web3. But nevertheless, Web3 is kind of having a very good foundation for many projects to build on and many, many projects to come to benefit from the availability of Web3 and the potential of Web3. Web3 actually, in fact, is originally called the semantic web by World Wide Web inventor Tim Berners-Lee, and it's aimed at being more autonomous, intelligent, and open internet, meaning that there are no limits and there are no centralization. This is a decentralized internet. The definition can be expanded as following, and it can be interconnected in a decentralized way, which could be a huge leap forward to the current generation of the internet, which is Web 2.0, that usually stores all the data on a centralized storage, but Web3 will just have it in a decentralized way, scattered all over the place by all users. So that's the power of Web3, and that's why all the machine learning, all the AI technology, all the emerging technologies have to have a look here at Web3 and have to utilize the Web3 until the maximum opportunity for them to grow. So we can go now for the ways companies can utilize Web3 to gain more competitive advantages. Here you can utilize Web3 for better onboarding and user journeys, meaning that you can have the blockchain technology, especially in Web3, that can be used to provide users with simple and more user-friendly onboarding process, meaning that a good example of how this works is using your Facebook login of access. I mean, you can just have a very intuitive and very easy to use and very fluid way to access your profile, and that can be used machine learning, artificial intelligence, and the blockchain technology on top. So things are using the blockchain technology, things are using Web3 in a very good way to have a more pleasant experience and seamless experience for apps and for access for data. Blockchain uses the same approach, but with the important difference here, unlike Facebook, of course, and many tech giants, it doesn't store the user's information. It is actually on the blockchain, meaning that it's anonymous and it's not really being able to be hacked. The blockchain technology is impenetrable. I mean, blockchain technology means that every transaction, every bit of information is in a blockchain, but that cannot be accessed and it cannot be stored in a centralized place. It's a decentralized concept, and this will give more security and more flexibility, of course. So on the onboarding Web3 tech stacks, as you can see here, this will aid the creation of efficient and effective customer journey, and this will use artificial intelligence AI to enable certain elements in the process to be automated, meaning that it will be seamless and the businesses will be able to allocate resources more efficiently and just cut human involvement as much as they can. Of course, this will also lead to a better customer engagement. When a customer is having a pleasant experience, when a customer is having a seamless transition into what he needs, of course he will have a better customer experience, and the Web3 technologies here eliminates the need for third-party ID verification, which is again good news for customers, meaning that you don't have to give the internet users control over your own data. You don't have to give any sensitive information, your place of birth or date of birth or where you're living or your bank account details or whatever, meaning that you can be secured and safe in terms of how data is processed and how your data is handled and stored as well. And here the Web3 can actually offer a new approach to engaging with customers and collecting valuable information about their behavior. Instead of relying on the stored data, this will be and that can be an ad supported marketing models, and the companies can use a decentralized model to align economies across all users, meaning that the Web3 approach will be more friendly to customers and customers will have a better engagement and a better experience all in all. So customers will benefit and also the business itself will benefit and will have a competitive advantage in the market and in the area they're working on. And here this will open new opportunities for innovation, particularly here through NFTs. NFTs is a major player in the game right now. Everyone is talking about NFT, of course. NFT is just taking the whole entire world by storm, and currently it's just all about NFT, and it's all about how the NFT is being handled. I mean, luxury brands now are just pushing consumers to buy virtual versions of the projects through in games through the NFT marketplaces. NFT actually is well integrated into the metaverse, meaning that you can have 2D NFTs, 3D NFTs, or virtual reality NFTs, which is in the metaverse. So you can have that all opportunities for innovation, for the human mind to go wild and to create weird things, to create out of the box things. And this can be utilized and built upon the Web3 and built on the blockchain technology and be utilized here for businesses to grow their competitive advancement here and to gain good advancement in the market and be ahead in terms of innovation and in terms of how they are kind of rapidly growing and how they can strategically built some goods or some services for their business. So there are further uses for the tech stack as well for Web3 and has to offer here. The good use, for example, is Google is constantly working on the development of its augmented and virtual reality technology in the context of geolocation, and that can produce 3D maps to help customers find your business within the VR set. You can just wear the VR set and you can just have a virtual map around you, and it will help locate your favorite store within VR set itself. So it's endless possibilities and endless potential here. And as I told you, luxury brands are trying to push now and allowing customers to buy the virtual version of the project, of the product they have. You can buy the physical thing in real world, and you can also buy a virtual version of the same thing in the metaverse or in the form of NFT, non-fungible token. Always remember, non-fungible token. This will have a huge impact in the very near future, probably within the next few years or so. You'll find that NFT marketplace is growing so much, and many good usage for the NFTs and NFT marketplaces can benefit many businesses out there to go wild with innovation and also to have competitive advantages in terms of how they're developing their projects and products and services to consumers. And this will have a very good impact on the consumer side and also on the business side and the development side. So things are looking quite bright here, and I would advise you to have a look and inform yourself more about this whole new concept and how things are evolving in the Web3 and in the NFT industry, and also in the terms of blockchain, how things are moving fast nowadays.
So guys, in a nutshell, we talked about Web3 technologies and how companies can utilize that to gain competitive advantages and how they can utilize the technologies available nowadays to get ahead in the market. So if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, leave any comment you might have in the comment section down below, and until next one, bye-bye.